origin of oil and natural gas. What do you see in this picture? You see marine creatures. When they die, settle to the muddy bottom, preserved and buried along with sediment. And when the sediment get buried more deeply, the temperature and pressure increase, and the organic matter of marine creature change it into oil and gas. This is the origin of oil and natural gas from marine creature living in ocean and lakes. This marine creature, when decayed, it changed into oil and gas, and this process takes thousands of years. Petroleum and natural gas considered from energy resources. Petroleum is crude oil, means flammable liquid, consists of organic compound. Natural gas consists of organic compound methane. Oil and natural gas are useful fuel for several reasons. They have a very high heat content. They cost less than coal to transport, and they are easy to transport. They can be refined easily to form useful material. Both of them are used as raw material named feedstock. Feedstock used in making plastic and many other synthetic compounds. It is used in making paints, insecticides, fertilizers. In addition, natural gas is a raw material used in antifreeze, clothing dyes, also photographic films, and the explosives. Oil and natural gas are found in poor spaces of sedimentary rocks. The raw material for generation of oil and gas is organic matter deposited with the sediment. And by increasing depth, the temperature and the pressure increase. As we said before, so the organic matter changed into oil and gas. This process called the maturation. Petroleum geologists called this process maturation, the change of organic matter into oil and gas. And the oil window or gas window is the range of depth for generation of oil and gas. So oil window is the range of depths suitable for generation of oil and gas. Finally, the kitchen is the region which is rich in organic matter. The source rocks for oil and gas are mudstone and shale. Pay attention that the source rocks for oil and gas are mudstone and shale. They are impermeable rocks, and the fluids can flow through them slowly. Oil and gas rise and percolate through the source rocks. Because oil and gas are less dense than water. When they reach fractures and permeable rocks, they can move more rapidly. Permeable rocks such as sandstone and limestone. So the permeable rocks of sandstone and limestone considered the reservoir rocks. They can move more rapidly. so oil and gas rise to the Earth's surface, forming oil and gas seeps. Seeps means spill out or flowing of petrol. Or produce tar mats. Tar is a black material, has high viscosity. You understand? Oil and gas rise through the source rock because of less density of them, and they reach the fracture and the permeable rocks of sandstone and limestone and move rapidly. Type. If these rocks capped deep in the earth, capped means covered by impermeable layer of rocks. This impermeable layer that cover the rocks which contain oil and gas called the seal. The oil and gas in this case are prevented from moving up. And when oil and gas trapped and accumulate beneath a seal, they form a petroleum reservoir. Large porous rock containing oil and gas covered with a seal is called a reservoir. Oil and gas can be brought to the surface by drilling deep wells into the reservoir. This is the reservoir. Reservoir of petrol, or named trap. The trap contain sedimentary rocks and in between oil and natural gas. And because of density, of less density of oil and natural gas, they go upward. And the seal covered the rocks which contain oil and gas. The seal is a mass of impermeable rock, has convex upward shape. But the closure of the reservoir. Let us see the closure of the reservoir. It is the distance, vertical distance from the top of the seal to its lower edge where petroleum can spill out. Giant petroleum reservoir have closure of many tens of meters, and they have horizontal dimension or width 1,000 meters. Large reservoir can hold hundreds of millions of barrels of oil. Petroleum reservoir around the world range in age from more than a billion years to just a few million years. Geologically, this is very young. So why are oil and gas considered from non-renewable resources? Because the generation of petroleum operates on time scale far longer than human lifetime. It takes a long time to form oil, more than human life. So it is non-renewable resource. Porosity and permeability. We said that most sedimentary rocks have open spaces in addition to solid material. They are the most porous rocks, example sandstone. So porosity is the measure of a percentage of pores in a material. Porosity equal volume of pore spaces divided by solid volume of material and multiplied by 100, expressed in as percentage. The porosity of sand about 30 to 40%, and if the sand particles have more size, the porosity decrease. When the sand buried in sedimentary rocks to great depths, temperature and pressure increase, and new material formed called cement deposited around the sand grain and the sediment and changed the loose fragment into rock. The cement reduced the porosity of the rock. The most productive petroleum reservoir rocks have pore spaces and are not isolated by cement. When the pore spaces are connected, the fluid can flow slowly through the rock depending on the fluid pressure. The fluid pressure differs from one place to another. So the rate of flow through the porous material according to pressure difference is called the permeability of the material. The rate of flow. Through the porous material according to the pressure difference called the permeability of material. The rock that has high permeability also has high porosity. Good petroleum reservoirs must have high porosity to hold oil and gas, and has high permeability so that oil and gas can flow through the rock to bottom of a well. Egyptian geological map. Geological mapping of petroleum researches proved that we have Gamma field along western side of Suez Gulf. Western side of Suez Gulf, Gamasa field, and the oil fields of Alamin. Abu Gharadi and Razzaq in the western desert. Natural gas was discovered in Abu Madi in the Nile Delta. And in Abu Qir Bay in the Mediterranean Sea. Recent exploration in Western Desert led to economic oil and gas discoveries in the area of Badr al-Din, Khalda, Abu Sinan, Umm Baraka. Plenty of oil were reported in the offshore area northeast Bursaid. Geologists carry out detailed analysis to determine shape and extent of discovered traps nature to increase the reserves for economic growth and welfare of the coming generation. Search about petroleum or crude oil, feedstock, source rock, seal, reservoir and the cement. Finally, we have finished and we have talked about the nature of petroleum and natural gas, the origin of petroleum and gas, importance of petroleum and gas, the trap, porosity and permeability, fields of oil in Egypt. Thank you all very much and we will meet again.